In 1938, trolley cars made their last runs in San Jose. These cars had provided transportation for Santa Clara residents since the turn of the century. Today, 50 years later, trolleys are making a comeback. I'm Ken Blase, and in this program, we'll take a look at why the trolleys are returning to San Jose. With me is Rod Diridon, Santa Clara County Supervisor and President of the San Jose Trolley Corporation. Rod has been responsible for much of the success in making this comeback. Rod, why the renewed interest in trolleys?
Well, Ken, I think there are two reasons. First is that transportation is the biggest problem facing Santa Clara Valley right now. We've seen this in survey after survey, and all you have to do is ride the freeways and commute hours, and you know that to be true. So people are relating to all kinds of transportation, trolleys and otherwise. The second is the nostalgia involved. People are kind of yearning for a calmer time and a time when there was more heart and more feeling, and these trolleys represent that calmer time.
There's been a lot of discussion about light rail transit also. How does that differ from trolleys, or does it?
It really does. Light rail transit, although they use trolley tracks and the overhead wires, are great huge cars. They're about 2.5 times as big as the little trolleys, and they go much faster, and they're kind of space-age technology, while the historic trolleys are really from turn-of-the-century technology.
Rod, we've talked about the trolleys and about the light rail. Don't they come together in some bigger project that you call the Guadalupe Corridor Project?
Oh, it sure does. These historic cars will be using the rails that we're building for the Guadalupe Corridor Project, which goes from the Great America area in Santa Clara all the way down First Street through downtown San Jose in the mall and downtown San Jose, and then all the way out into South San Jose into the IBM area in Almaden Valley area. The little historic cars, though, are going to be operating primarily on the transit mall, that 10-block long, 2-block wide loop in downtown San Jose from San Carlos Street to Divine Street on 1st and 2nd. That's where they're primarily going to be functioning. They can function up and down the tracks, too, but there'll be a shopper shuttle primarily in that downtown loop.
And that loop is going to be called the Transit Mall?
Yes, so we're spending $40 million, just under $40 million on granite and street trees and art objects and fountains and all sorts of things to make that the center point for transportation for all of the South Bay area. And the historic trolleys will be the focal point of that center point by shuttling people around that oval.
There's a light rail feeds into this. Do you have already provided for parking areas so commuters can and will actually use the trains?
Oh, I think so, yes. All up and down the south end, where the residential end is primarily, we have park and ride lots, so people can drive their car or take a bus to the park and ride lot, then get onto the big light rail vehicle. The big vehicle then goes through the transit mall and drops people off, and then the little trolleys, the little historic trolleys, shuttle them around to the different locations along that transit mall.
What kind of a timetable can commuters expect?
Well, the Guadalupe Corridor project will be done in the north end at the end of 1987, and then the south end and the mall area mid-1988 to mid-1989.
And how often do the trains run?
Well, the trains will run during commute hours at about 7-minute intervals. So 7 minutes between cars. During off-peak, it'll be about a half hour.
So inconvenience won't be an excuse?
No. You'll be able to get on the bus near your house, take the bus down to the station, take the train down to the mall, and pick up an historic trolley ride.
Sounds great.
As was pointed out, an extensive transportation plan known as the Guadalupe Corridor Transit Project is underway. What we're seeing now is an illustration of the route, beginning near the IBM plant in South San Jose. This plan includes a light rail transit system, expanded expressways, bicycle lanes, and a beautiful new transit mall in downtown San Jose. The mall is just blocks from San Jose State University, the Center for the Performing Arts, the new convention center, office buildings, and hundreds of restaurants and shops. The goal of this ambitious plan is to move people through the valley from the residential areas of South and Eastern San Jose to downtown and on north to the high-tech and research and development parks in the so-called Golden Triangle. The completed project will be 20 miles in length with 31 stations along the way. Light rail vehicles were chosen as one of the answers to the transportation problem because they are clean, quiet, and offer a comfortable ride. They're powered by overhead electric wires, and the steel wheels driven by electric motors run along steel tracks. A special maintenance facility is now ready for operation and is awaiting the arrival of the first of the light rail vehicles.
Three elements have combined to make this success for Santa Clara County. First of all is the enormous growth and prosperity our valley, which has generated the need and the demand for modern rapid transit. Secondly, is the strong support of this project by local governments and the broader community. And I cannot overemphasize the importance of the commitment that has been shown here in Santa Clara County. The enthusiasm and the willingness to back that enthusiasm with a local financial commitment. And the third ingredient of our success has been the dogged determination of our Grand Master Conductor, Supervisor Rod Diridon.
Geographically, at the midpoint of the 20-mile-long Guadalupe Corridor is the heart of downtown San Jose and the Transit Mall area. This will become the transportation hub in San Jose, integrating rail, highway, and pedestrian movement. Transit malls are often part of general downtown development strategies. The mall will bring many improvements to downtown and is being developed at the same time as other major redevelopment projects. The mall will include street trees and special red and green granite paving. It will feature historic twin acorn style light fixtures, transit shelters, and street furniture. The downside of the project has been the negative impact of long-term construction. Dust, noise, and traffic constraints have made it difficult to get around the downtown area. However, the finished mall and transportation improvements should quickly reverse the negative effects and provide tremendous assets to the retail, business, and development communities.
San Jose is going to be an extraordinary place in just a few years right here in the downtown. First Street and San Carlos Street and Santa Clara Street, all of this 60 square blocks down here is going to be as it was. And when I say as it was, I'm not hearkening back to a bygone era. It's going to be like it was when people could come down here, when they could shop, when they could eat, when they could have entertainment, when they could bring their families, when they could feel comfortable, and maybe most importantly, when they could feel proud about the city of San Jose.
As we saw at the beginning of the show, another community transportation project is also underway, the restoration of San Jose's historic trolleys. When the groundbreaking ceremony for the Transit Mall was held in July 1985, one of San Jose's historic trolleys was on hand. The crowd was treated to a sneak preview of what is to come.
And ground has been broken, ladies and gentlemen, for the Transit Mall.
Now at the San Jose Trolley Barn, where the actual restoration work is taking place on these historic cars. And as you can see, this barn, which was specially built for this purpose, is actually bursting at the seams.
San Jose Trolley Corporation was established in 1982. There were no trolleys. By 1983, two San Jose cars had been located and moved to this site. These cars were not in good shape, but it appeared that at least one of them could be restored. The next car to arrive at the trolley barn was this one from Sacramento. Charles Smallwood, an expert on the California trolley system, donated this car to the Trolley Corporation. This car carries the number 129 at Mr. Smallwood's request and will be one of the first to run on the downtown transit mall. As the restoration work picked up steam and more people became involved, the search for more cars continued. During the past 2 years, the Trolley Corporation has purchased trolleys from Portugal, Italy, and Australia. This smaller trolley from Portugal arrived in Oakland in October of 1985. By December, it was ready for display at the San Jose Christmas in the Park exhibit. Two trolleys were brought in from Milan, Italy. These are real people movers and have a different look from our San Jose trolleys. At least one of these cars will be used for parts. Bill Hunter and his wife Jan have been involved with this project from the very beginning. Bill, how'd you find out about this car in Santa Cruz?
A gentleman by the name of Bill Wolf, who's a historian of Los Gatos, was kind enough to give us the information that there were several streetcars bodies in Santa Cruz, California, and gave us an outline of where these might be. And myself, my wife, and Bruce Stevens went over and toured Santa Cruz, and by golly, Bill Wolf was right. We did find, as a matter of fact, four Santa Cruz streetcars, and this being one of them. In fact, there are two of these cars just like this. There were, I should say, two at the time in Santa Cruz, and we have at least the one of them here.
You know anything about the history of this car?
Oh, yes, we certainly do. And the beautiful part is that the car has given us more history. Originally, it was thought that this car was built for Santa Cruz in 1907. As it turns out, and digging through the layers of paint on this car, the car in reality was not car one in Santa Cruz built new. It was car number 9 built for Sacramento, by Sacramento.
Well, what made you think this car was worth saving?
Well, first of all, we looked at it and we felt that it was worth jacking up the termites and bringing them over because, first of all, even if it was seriously deteriorated, that the car could yield a great deal of history about its past.
What's unique about this car, though, Bill, as opposed to other cars? Each one seems to have its own uniqueness.
It has one feature, however, which is not unique to Sacramento and to Santa Cruz, which is not to San Jose, and the fact that the side can be removed from this car for the summertime. So this is called a full convertible.
Bill, I commented that this car is in pretty lousy shape. Do you think it is really going to be restored and run on the streets of downtown San Jose?
Oh, absolutely. It certainly won't be the first car down there, and it may be close to the last one down there, but it will definitely be one of our cars for downtown San Jose. It's too much of a piece of history not to go.
Fred Bennett was hired as project manager, and Herb Schrader became the volunteer coordinator. Soon volunteers were signing up to tackle this challenging restoration project, and what a challenge.
Fred, how long have you been in trolley restoration work?
Well, I worked in the two trolley museums that are in Connecticut for 35 years, off and on as an employee and as a volunteer, doing all kinds of mechanical, electrical, and woodworking on the cars there.
Fred, what kind of restoration work is going on now?
We're installing seats, polishing brass, and working on mahogany woodwork for the next car. And we're doing electrical work on the cars and air plumbing for the air pipes for the air brake.
Fred, how does this restoration project differ from other projects you've been involved with?
Yeah, this project is unique in that these cars will actually run in downtown San Jose. The other projects usually are off in some museum out in the country someplace.
And also, I understand you're working on quite a variety of cars in this project.
Oh, yes, we have 6 cars, and they'll all be slightly different, and some of them will be quite different. And they'll be all different colors, with different histories.
Will the cars be ready when the transit mall is ready downtown?
Oh, yes, surely. Sure, they'll be ready.
Retired craftsmen, students, young couples, and numerous organizations have donated over 30,000 hours to this restoration project. Today, we see the results of their hard work and dedication.
Now you're putting on gold leaf here. Putting it on the gold size, it's already been put on and it's a little tacky. Gold is very, very thin and hard to work with because it's so fragile. Here's the cotton. We rub it off with rub the excess gold leaf off with the cotton.
Just like that?
Yeah.
Real lightly?
Yeah, real lightly. So you're removing the excess around the edges and the little scraps help fill in some of the little cracks that are missing.
All right, the lathe was donated by a company that had been in business for about 100 years, and the children didn't want to take over the company, so the owner of the company donated the threading machine, the lathe, a shaper outside, and a drill press here to the car barn for use here. And when it came in here, this lathe hadn't been used in 40 years. So you can imagine how filthy it was. It took me 2 weeks scraping the dirt and filth off of it and cleaning it up and painting it. And then we were surprised when we got it running that it ran so quiet and so good. And right now I've been making this part is for the seat, the ends of the seat where they can adjust it. And this part is a part that goes over the bearing that is for the post of the door hinge where you go in and out of the car. And this is also a part that was made, that's made to hold the bearing in where the shaft will go through. And this is for another part of the door. So primarily that's what I've been doing for the last 3-4 weeks is making these parts.
Hi, Michelle.
Hi, Herb.
How you doing there? You're having a lot of fun. Doing a nice job.
Hi, Jeannie. Here, I've got it pretty nice just for you and then to your own panel.
Thank you very much. Here, well, listen, I'll give it right back to you, all right?
You would, thank you.
It's quite a job there getting that off, isn't it, Dave?
Yeah?
Yeah. Well, you only got 150 more to do.
Did he say 150?
John, would you explain to us what you're doing here today?
Okay, Fred. I'm working on brass handrail straps from car number 73 behind us. And they are rough cast to begin with and have these holes that have to be drilled for the bar that actuates the upper windows, bell strap, and, of course, the mounting holes. They come rather rough and have to be worked down successively finer and finer with handwork and machine work to the finished product that is rather shiny, as you can see. In the final stages, they'll be clear coated so they don't tarnish afterwards.
Okay, what we're working on here is a refurbishing a seat cushion for our trolley car, and this is what the finished product looks like, the top side and the underside. And these cushions are made up of a lot of components, and what we really start with is a wooden frame. And it has 5 slats across the bottom, and on each one of the slats we assemble one of these spring mechanisms. We have to rivet 3 springs onto each one of these metal strips, and then they get fastened to the wooden slat, and then there'll be 5 of them along on each cushion. And then we cut a canvas strip, and this strip is riveted onto the metal strip and then tacked onto the wooden frame so that we have 5 of those here, and then the whole deal is covered with a kind of a felt cushioning material, and then another canvas layer is put on top of that, and then we give it the final covering with the rattan material. It's a lot of handwork goes into one little cushion.
All right, these are the curtains that go on the car 124, like you see on there. We're putting them on the rollers here today and have to tape them on with this tape. So the first thing we have to do is get this tape. Barry, you want to hold that so we can... And then lay that down just right. Okay, Bob got it there. Thank you. There's our T-square. Have to get these square exactly or else they will not roll up straight. And that's one of the tricks. This is the right end. Roll back on there to make it stick. And lightly put that down because it may not come out right the first time. Hey, golly, I think it did. That's very good. Rolled up straight.
We're fabricating seat brackets for car 129. And this is it.
Thank you.
trolley restoration project has involved hundreds of people and has received support from many major contributors in the community. Rod, who are some of the major contributors who've helped with this project?
Well, Ken, as you've said, we've really received help from literally hundreds of people. But the major keystone givers are what we call the trolley sponsors. Now, the trolley sponsors give $150,000 apiece, and they are, to date, are Gil Cable, the Coleshaw Corporation, Fairmont Hotel, Metro A Trust Fund, San Jose Mercury and News, and the Hugh Center Trust Fund. Those folks have given $150,000 apiece. That money's in the bank, and that's what's being used now to pay for this restoration project.
Rod, in addition to the cash contributions, you've mentioned in-kind contributions or services. What does that entail?
In-kind services are things like the big rigging company that carried the cars from the port of entry in Oakland or from the apartment building that we had to tear down around one of the cars in Santa Cruz and so on and brought them here at no charge to the project. People who have given the woods and the steel and the different kinds of special products that go into the cars. We've paid for very little of that. Most of the people have given it to us.
And all the money and all the material wouldn't mean much if it weren't for the people who work here putting it together.
The key ingredient is the group of volunteers that work on this project from day to day, and they're here all the time. Any time of the day and night, you're going to come down here and you're going to find some volunteers down here working on a trolley car. And they love it. It's a kind of a thing that's an uplifting kind of experience because you can see these old cars coming back to life.
As we have seen, San Jose is in a transition stage. Efficient transportation is a foundation for planned growth. Major highway improvements, the new light rail system, and attractive downtown San Jose Transit Mall are all ingredients for success. These colorful, restored trolleys will add a sense of history while providing a practical solution to downtown transportation.